Health Watch. Today is World Pancreatic Cancer Day, a day to bring awareness to one of the world's deadliest cancers.
That's right. Every day, more than 1,200 people worldwide will be diagnosed with this type of cancer. It has the lowest survival rate amongst all the major cancers. Julie Fleshman is the president and CEO of the Pancreatic Cancer Action Network, and she joins us here. Good to see you. Let's start with the basics. What is pancreatic cancer, and why is it so deadly?
So pancreatic cancer is one of the toughest cancers. The five-year survival rate is just 9%. And one of the things that makes it really tough is there is no early detection method. So by the time it's diagnosed, it's late stage and difficult to treat. And we also need more research funding. There hasn't been enough effort to really find new treatment options and an early detection strategy.
So there isn't sort of a system of testing like there is for breast cancer, but there must be symptoms. What are some of the early symptoms?
So many of the symptoms are benign, which also makes it tough. Things like stomach ache, lower back pain, unexplained weight loss, jaundice, the yellowing of the skin and the eyes, new onset diabetes. Those are some of the things that if you have more than one of those symptoms, you should really go in and talk to your doctor about pancreatic cancer.
But because a lot of these symptoms are just the symptoms of living, right?
Yes.
I mean, back pain, everybody has back pain,
right.
Digestive problems.
Yes.
I've got a lot of those symptoms,
yes.
Right? So how do you know when you really should go in?
So certainly just having back pain is probably not an indication of pancreatic cancer. But if you have multiple, you know, look, and if you have several of these symptoms, and listen to your body. Everybody needs to be their own best advocate. And if something is persistently bothering you, go in and talk to your doctor.
Have any maybe common factors been identified or risk factors? Who's most likely to get this diagnosis?
So some of the risk factors, there is about 10% of patients, there is a familial risk, hereditary pancreatitis, long-standing diabetes, and then just age. You know, as we age, we're more susceptible to things like cancer. Mm-hmm. And there's a full list of risk factors and symptoms at pancan.org.
How do you treat it?
So there are many clinical trials actually going on for pancreatic cancer, which is wonderful. There are lots of options. Usually it's treated through some sort of chemotherapy and radiation. If it's detected early enough and hasn't spread, some patients are eligible for surgery.
So then, you know, how can you help? What can people do? How can they get involved if, you know, okay, we're raising awareness. What else can you do?
Absolutely. So we need to raise more funds. We need to fund research. We need to provide services for patients and families. So people can go to pancan.org. We have affiliates all around the country where people are getting involved in walk events called Purple Stride. They can make a donation. And we have wonderful services for patients and families that are currently dealing with the disease.
Pancan.org. Thank you, Julie, for being here. Appreciate it.
Thank you.